Legend has it, at the end of the Shang Dynasty, Emperor Zhao was cruel and incompetent. After taking advantage of the chaos and transforming into beauty, the nine-tailed fox bewitched Emperor Zhao and wreaked havoc in the world. The emergence of the nine-tailed fox led to chaos in the world, and the common folk suffered. To overthrow the tyrant and restore peace to the world, the Revered Master sent Jiang Xia to lead the gods against the nine-tailed fox. After a protracted war, Jiang Xia overthrew the Shang Dynasty. He captured the nine-tailed fox and established immoral achievements. As a reward, Jiang Xia should have been named the leader of the gods. At the sealing ceremony, the Revered Master ordered Jiang Xia to kill the nine-tailed fox. But when Jiang Xia was about to take action, he saw another girl's soul hidden in the nine-tailed fox's body. If the nine-tailed fox is killed, the girl would undoubtedly be dead as well. In order not to hurt the innocent, setting free the souls of the nine-tailed fox and the girl, Jiang Xia only destroyed the physical body of the nine-tailed fox. Knowing this, the Revered Master was so furious that he sealed Jiang Xia's divine power and deported him to the North Sea, where he asked Jiang Xia to reflect. Once Jiang Xia recognized his mistakes, he would be allowed to return and be leader of the gods again. How time flies. 10 years have passed. The world has taken earth-shaking changes. Jiang Xia is still exiled. He sits by the lake every day and enjoys fishing. However, Jiang Xia isn't living an exile life alone, for his junior fellow apprentice, Shen Gongbao, has always been with him. Because of the harsh environment in the North Sea, one has to barter with the owner of the tavern if one wants food. One day, when Jiang Xia is buying food, a strange girl breaks into the house. The girl's name is Xiao Zhu, and she is not a native of the North Sea. But Jiang Xia is shocked when he glances at Xiao Zhu. Because this face can't be more familiar to him, it is exactly the face that made him free the nine-tailed fox mistakenly, resulting in his 10-year exile in the North Sea. As soon as Jiang Zhu enters, she inquires about the news of Yaodu Mountain with the store owner. It turns out that Yaodu Mountain used to be an immortal mountain, where Emperor Zhao was deified as the god of marriage. But these past 2 years, someone has found fox demons haunting the mountains, which arises widespread concern from the outside world. It is said that the mountains now blooms with flowers all over, even blocking the way into the mountain. Only with the map owned by the shopkeeper can one get there smoothly. In the North Sea, everything is clearly priced. Because Xiao Zhu has no money, she has to grab the map and then run away. In her escape, Xiao Zhu's hat is knocked off, revealing the ears of the fox demons hidden below. It's well known that if one can capture the fox demon and hand it over to the Revered Master, one can get infinite rewards, and it's even possible to become a god. The outlaws in the tavern suddenly get excited and join the battle of catching Xiao Zhu together. During the fight, the map is swallowed by Zhang Xia's mystical beast, Zebuxiang. But no time permitting to worry about that, Xiao Zhu has to escape the pub first. Zhang Xia follows her closely. The girl is about to run out of the border of the North Sea. If Zhang Xia follows her and crosses the border, it means challenging the authority of the Revered Master. But to solve the inward doubt bothering him, he can't care so much. As dusk approached, the girl has run all the way to the woods. With all her attention focused on Zhang Xia behind her, she doesn't notice something unexpected hidden in the woods. A wave of black resentful souls comes out of the woods and wraps Xiao Zhu around, trying to take her away. Fortunately, Zhang Xia arrives in time and saves her. He has the red bracelet on Xiao Zhu's ankle, which is exclusive to the nine-tailed fox. As he asks Xiao Zhu about the origin of the bracelet, but Xiao Zhu says that she has lost all her memory, and therefore, she has no idea of the bracelet's origin. But the bracelet has been pointing to Yaodu Mountain for her, where maybe she can find her father, and then everything will come to light. In this way, in order to find Xiao Zhu's life experience and solve the doubts that plague him, Zhang Xia decides to search for the road leading to Yaodu Mountain together with Xiao Zhu. Along the way, they bump into a dying man who was a member of the fox hunting team. Since the news of the discovery of the fox demon in Yaodu Mountain, there are many people like him who go to Yaodu Mountain to hunt foxes to gain glory and wealth. As a kind-hearted man, Zhang Xia is reluctant to stand by, which makes Xiao Zhu very unhappy. Heartbroken, Xiao Zhu decides to get to Yaodu Mountain by herself, but she doesn't notice that the blood she accidentally drips activates the resentful souls sleeping on the battlefield. Once united, the resentful souls are so powerful that even Zhang Xia, who comes to save her, is no match for it. During the fight between the two sides, the resentful souls knock down Zhang Zhu's backpack, and the bone-made wind chimes inside fall out. Then, something magic happens. After hearing the sound of wind chimes, the souls calm down as if they were soothed. But these souls will not really rest in peace because they are soldiers who died in the Great War. Zhang Jia tells Zhao Zhu that in the ninth heaven, there is a mysterious bird called Swallow. Only when the birds descend can these resentful souls truly reincarnate, which hasn't been witnessed. At night, Zhang Jia and Zhao Zhu talk about the Great War. Back then, they all thought that by killing the nine-tailed fox, the world would regain peace. But after the war, the world became more desolate than before. Just as they are chatting, a blue figure suddenly slides across the dark sky. Surprisingly, the legendary Swallow in the ninth heaven really descends to the mortal realm. It takes away the resentful souls who died in the war and also brings hope. Its tail draws a splendid Milky Way in the night sky, the end of which is the location of Yaodu Mountain. Guided by the Milky Way, the two soon come to the foot of Yaodu Mountain. However, just as they are about to climb the mountain, Xinggong Bao rushes over and stops them. It turns out that Xinggong Bao is constantly worried about Zhang Jia, so he has been secretly following them. Fearing that Zhang Jia may be confused by the fox demon, Xinggong Bao catches Yang Zhu and requires her to answer all his questions. Zhang Jia hurriedly steps forward to stop him, but it's still a step late. To save Zhang Zhu, Zibuxiang has been so beaten that he flies out. In the search for Zibuxiang, Zhang Zhu accidentally breaks into the interior of Yaodu Mountain. Yaodu Mountain is the territory of Emperor Zhao. He catches Zhang Zhu and presses her to tell him the whereabouts of the nine-tailed fox. It turns out that Emperor Zhao has long noticed the red bracelet on Zhao Zhu's foot, and he knows the true origin of it. In fact, this red bracelet is the legendary Lock of Destiny, and the two people who are connected by the lock will live and die together. And another one connected by the lock is the Nine-Tailed Fox. Now, as long as the Lock of Destiny is manifested, the Nine-Tailed Fox can be found again. To get the whereabouts of his beloved, Emperor Zhao decides to use force to question Zhang Zhu. In the distance, hearing Zhang Zhu's heartbreaking screams, Zhang Jia rushes desperately to the mountains, but he is late. Because of Emperor Zhao's torture, Zhang Zhu gradually loses consciousness, her body erupting in a burst of red light. The red light attracts a group of fox demons, and they take Zhang Zhu away. Zhang Jia hurriedly chases after them. However, the worst situation happens when the fox demons bring Zhao Zhu to the nine-tailed fox. Except for Zhang Jia, no one can imagine that the nine-tailed fox, which should have died several years ago, would reappear in the mortal realm again. Seeing that everyone is stunned, the nine-tailed fox slowly relates the truth of the year. It turns out that Zhang Zhu's real name is Su Daji, and on the day she got married, the nine-tailed fox occupied her body and became the consort of the Shang dynasty, while Su Daji was locked by Lock of Destiny and could never get away. Back then, in order not to hurt the innocent, Zhang Jia let go of the soul of the nine-tailed fox. But unexpectedly, Zhang Zhu also took the opportunity to escape from the shackles of the nine-tailed fox and also took away part of the demon power of the nine-tailed fox to reshape her physical body. The reason for the nine-tailed fox grabbing Zhao Zhu is to regain her demon power. Hearing this, Zhang Jia and Xinggong Bao can't be more careful. They want to join hands to save Zhao Zhu. To save Zhao Zhu, the Lock of Destiny must be destroyed first. However, unexpectedly, the moment when they attack the Lock of Destiny, the smell of the Revered Master appears and protects the lock. It turns out that the lock is actually related to the Revered Master. The moment the two are in a daze, the Nine-Tailed Fox has sucked away her demon power from Zhang Zhu. Since the Nine-Tailed Fox has recovered all her power, Zhang Jia and Xinggong Bao are no match for her. Seeing that the three are about to die here, Zibuxiang desperately resists the Nine-Tailed Fox, and then they successfully run away. But Zibuxiang is seriously injured. When Zhao Zhu is grieving, Zibuxiang turns into a burst of light and disappears. Xinggong Bao tells Zhang Jia that the Revered Master won't let go of the Nine-Tailed Fox. If the Lock of Destiny remains locked, Zhao Zhu will die along with the Nine-Tailed Fox. If they want to unlock it, they can only turn to the Revered Master. However, with this divine power sealed, Zhang Jia is unable to approach the Revered Master. To help him, Xinggong Bao opens the heavenly stairs for Zhang Jia at the expense of his cultivation. On the stairs, facing the accusation of the Revered Master, Zhang Jia is fearless, and he bravely questions the Master. Zhang Jia's persistence brings a turning point. The Revered Master tells Zhang Jia that once the fate lock is locked, it's unbreakable in this life. But Zhang Jia can send Zhao Zhu to the ruins of return, she can be reborn, thus unlocking the Lock of Destiny. Learning this, Zhang Jia together with Xinggong Bao rushes to the ruins of return. Despite their quick move, the nine-tailed fox catches up. To buy time, Shengong Bao decides to stay and hold off the nine-tailed fox, but due to the huge power disparity between the two, Shengong Bao can't stop the nine-tailed fox even if he sacrifices himself. Before death, he recalls the scene of his first encounter with Jing Xia. Jing Xia has always been the hero he admires, so he follows Jing Xia to the North Sea, hoping that he can turn into his former image. On the other side, Jing Ju wakes up in Jing Xia's arm. Jing Xia tells her that as long as she enters the ruins of return, she can be reincarnated. In the afterlife, she will have her own family like ordinary people. With the emergence of golden light, a golden disc rises from the sea. Zhao Zhu reluctantly bids farewell to Zhang Xia and walks into the disc. Just when the disc is about to sink into the sea, the nine-tailed fox catches up. Zhang Xia wants to stop her, but he is no match for her at all. Nine-tailed fox laughs at him, saying that he knows nothing and that he is just a fool who is kept from the truth by the revered master. She soars at the top of her voice and breaks the disc. Unexpectedly, from the broken disc emerges thousands of resentful souls of the Fox Clan. There is no reincarnation in the ruins of return at all. It's just a cage for imprisoning souls. It turns out that back then, the Revered Master lured the Nine-Tailed Fox, promising her that if she connects with a human through the Lock of Destiny and helps him launch the Great War and unite the three realms, she can ascend to the heaven and become a god. But when the goal was reached, to cover up the truth, the Revered Master slew the Fox Clan and buried them in the bottomless abyss. After finishing this, the Nine-Tailed Fox and these resentful fox souls together turn into a huge red fox, which rushes into the sky, attempting to tear the sky apart. At the same time, a golden axe slowly descends from the sky. Zhao Zhu, also wrapped up by these resentful fox demons, has to face the giant axe together. Climbing up along the chain, Zhang Xiao wants to save Zhao Zhu, but because of the strong power of the resentful souls, he must first regain his divine power. He breaks the seal the Revered Master had put in his body. What's more, his body even breaks out a more powerful force than before. Because of this force, all the resentful stones are purified, and even the Lock of Destiny is unlocked. But he is still a step too late. The giant axe falling from the sky not only kills the nine-tailed fox, but also Zhao Zhu. Zhao Zhu turns into golden light and disappears before Zhang Xia. After the fox demons are exterminated, the Revered Master descends the heavenly stairs again and wants Zhang Xia to be the leader of the gods. However, in Zhang Xia's heart, there is nothing but wrath. He believes that there is still a lock uncut between heaven and earth, which is the shackle imposed on humans by the Revered Master. Walking to the middle of the heavenly stairs, Zhang Xia slowly rises his divine whip and then hits the heavenly stairs. Without the stairs, humans will no longer be blessed by the gods, but it also means that the gods can no longer impose shackles on humans. From then on, people can live by their own efforts, and there is no god high in the heaven anymore.